Dr. C here again. This time we're going to talk about salt and water. In this container, I have a saturated solution of salt water. That is, the water holds as much salt as it can. If I put more salt in there, it won't dissolve. Everybody knows the ocean is salty. Where did all that salt come from? Well, over billions of years, the fresh water falling on the land dissolved any natural salts such as sodium chloride that were in the rocks and the dirt that it passed through, and rivers eventually carried them out to the ocean where they stayed, because the salt does not evaporate from the oceans like water does to return as rain. Okay, so what about adding salt to water? What happens? First of all, the salt dissolves into the water, breaks up, sodium chloride breaks up into sodium and chlorine ions, and finds its way in between the open spaces in the water. So it makes the water denser because it doesn't increase the volume of the water. And when you dissolve a solid into a liquid, it does two things. It raises the boiling point and it lowers the freezing point. I have a container of water that is fully saturated with salt. I have another container of water that's dyed kind of purple, that has some salt dissolved in it, but not as much as this. And I have a beaker of just fresh water without any salt in it. And that's kind of a lime green, so that it can be differentiated. And what I'm going to do is pour these together, and if I do it right, very gently, there will be layers created of water floating on top of water in different densities. This will take a while, so I'll probably speed this up. Now on top of this, I will pour the perfectly fresh water. Again, very slowly, so there's not too much agitation. And if everything goes right, we should have a nice, whoops, I keep forgetting that fills up as I pour into it. It's mixed up quite a bit, but there are three separate layers. And this is important because as the ice caps melt and the glaciers melt, there's more fresh water released into the ocean, and that fresh water tends to ride above the salt water. That disrupts the natural currents that control the weather around the world. Thanks. I hope you enjoyed this session. Come back for another little knowledge nugget with Dr. C. Thank you.